am certainly looking forward to some laughs, y'all.
I need that medicine right now.
Welcome back to Eddie B TV. I am, of course, Eddie B. Nice to see y'all. We are back at you again today for another reaction video. And today we are going to get into some more from the comedian Blaq Ron today. Yes. Now, I've gotten to a couple of videos from him. Funny as hell. And I think the last one I got to was talking about exes or something like that. I don't remember. Being friends with your exes or something. It might have been something to that. And I had C-Dab, the CEO, with me on that one. And it was, it was an interesting little bit from him, you know. Touched on some personal stuff we all might be going through. But, I think that's part of his act. You know what I mean? I don't think he just tells jokes just to tell them. I think he tells life stories, you know. But, we're going to get into another one from him. And the title of this one's going to be Kids Don't Kiss Like They Used To. Wonder what that means. This might be referring to how childhood was then, just how you see childhood unfolding now. I don't know. Could be something like that. But we're going to see what he's talking about. So we all have childhoods. We all have twisted experiences in this life. But it definitely differs from person to person. You know, so let's see what he's talking about with his. So yeah, we're going to get into some Blaq Ron with Kids Don't Kiss Like They Used To. And if you like this reaction, please click on the like button for me one time. Subscribe to the channel, ring that bell, and leave a nice comment for your boy. Constructive critiques, leave a nice suggestion or request, and throw a couple jabs, jokes, and zingers at me. Friendly dialogue, no drama here, all right? You guys know the deal. So yeah, man, we're about to get into some more laughs, man, and continue this thing on. I'm trying every single day to keep putting out as much content as I can, you know, just getting to so much more stuff. And some days are better than others, you know, because I just be tired. But we are wide awake right now, so let's go ahead and do this. Blaq Ron with Kids Don't Kiss Like They Used To, right here on Eddie B TV. Back with the laughs, y'all. Let's have some fun. Right here we go. Shout out Chocolate Sundaes, by the way.
Let's talk about it. Let's talk about the progression of sex. Like, these kids these days jump straight to the... It's levels to this.
True.
Who remember when kissing was? Who remember?
Yeah, okay.
Who
I know
remember?
What you're talking about, man. Absolutely.
Boy, let a kiss get out in the streets. That should be all over that elementary school like Wendy Williams gossip. No sooner you get off the bus, guess what? What? Tyrone and Keisha was under the bleachers kissing. What?
Uh-oh. Yeah.
And your heart would be broken. Cause how could Keisha kiss another nigga like that? Fucking hoe all under the bleachers kissing another nigga, man.
Yeah, that's facts though.
And I gave that hoe my candy.
Oh hell no. We gonna get not my candy, bro.
Some of y'all wondering why a nigga like, who hurt you? Keisha back in fifth grade, bitch.
Yep.
It ain't even about you, goddamn me. This trauma is deep-seated.
He telling some stories right now. Oh, yeah.
We moved straight from kissing to on top of the bra titty touching.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to say it again slow. On top of the bra titty touching.
On top of the bra.
That's when you went under the shirt. But she was raised in a two-parent household, so you had to stay on top of the bra.
Two-parent.
You touched your titty a little bit. Went home with your hand just full of prepubescent titty.
Uh-oh. Yep.
By the time you got to eighth grade, it's time to take things up another notch.
Uh-oh.
It's time to go ahead and get the fingering.
Uh-oh.
Cause your cousin, he was an early bloomer. He had been fingering. This nigga come over to the house with enough DNA to be a goddamn sexual assault suspect under his goddamn thumbnail and middle finger, and will present the evidence to you. Smell this.
Oh no.
And like a dope fiend, your ass. What is that? Who is that? That smell reminiscent. I know.
Reminiscent. You're a damn fool.
So we were Somalis for that young cooch. It's a hint of Dove soap and smelling hints of oak and elderberry.
You fool, man.
And it was a whole task to finger you some coochie back then. Because the jeans was tall. Big jeans, goddamn me. Jean way up here, long zipper on them damn jeans. Don't let her have on no button flies. Shit, you might not never get to that damn promised land.
Hell no.
You had to have grown man hands to undo the damn buckles on some button fly damn jeans. You get through unfastening three of them WWF turnbuckles.
Turnbuckle.
Finally get them damn pants loose. What's waiting on you? Some tall draws right up under that motherfucker.
Come on.
Big draws, goddamn me. WWF SummerSlam draws. They way above the name. I'm gonna tell you something, brother. We don't get you in that Letterman's brother type draws. You got to be the Intercontinental Champion to get off in them goddamn draws.
Oh, come on, man. I ain't been on the show that long.
You finally get down past them drawers, and it was a whole bunch of coochie hair waiting on your ass. Yes, it was. Wasn't it a bunch of coochie hair? Yes. Dry, coarse, 4C coochie hair.
Oh, God.
Waiting on your ass. Wasn't no edge control on it or nothing.
Nope.
Wasn't no leave-in conditioner in it or nothing. Just straight from the motherland. Coochie hair waiting upon you. You got your damn hand wet. You got through them drawers and past them pants and through that whole bush. By the time you got to the spot and your hand dry, you gotta come back out. Reapply. And then go back down the trail you had just blazed for yourself. And that was success.
You ain't lying, man.
That was a great night. You went home with carpal tunnel and was like, yeah. Did that. But you didn't know that them was gonna be skills that you needed later on in your grown mandom. When you become somebody daddy. And they done dropped something in the sink. Your ass can take two fingers and get off in that damn drain with your eyes closed and pull an earring back out that bitch. Like, damn, daddy, where you get the MacGyver skills? Hey, Bray, don't worry about it.
Oh, man. That's good. Okay. Damn. Blaq Ron shows up again, man. He a damn fool for that one, man. He had me tapping into some old school happenings, man. Yeah, the title was a little bit deceiving at first, you know, but, you know, he made sense of it right away, you know, so no confusion there. Okay, very funny bit, man. That was Blaq Ron with Kids Don't Kiss Like They Used To. Well, man, he was absolutely right about, you know, your everyday normal kid, you know, that'll come into some sexuality, if you want to call it that. Unfortunately, you know, some people might just call me disgusting. I don't care, man. I came into a lot of things very early, earlier than I ever should have. You know, it was actually quite, you know, bad, you know what I mean, for, you know. But I was a sneaky kid in some ways, you know. Some ways I could play off like I didn't know things, and then other times I could just not know things and just like, yep, add that one to the list of things that I've done. I think the first time that I ever had a serious full-on kiss, I was maybe 4 or 5 years old. Yeah. And that was just, you know, like emulating what you see, what you can sneak see, you know, when parents are watching some whatever they watching on TV, or maybe your aunts or your uncles is watching some twisted stuff and you just like, oh, okay. I'm gonna try some of that crazy stuff. But yes, it was levels. Like he said, there was levels to it. You know, you start with like some kissing, and kissing was always the thing because it's almost like he said, it was sex. That's what kissing was to us, you know, prepubescent, and even like for the first few stages, first couple of stages of, you know, your puberty at post-pubescent. Yes, I can't even talk today. But yeah, you felt like, you know, wow, that made you feel some kind of way. Some tingling was going on in some places, man. And then you were just like, oh, to be a kid again, man. You know, I mean, sex is still important no matter what age you are, you know, up until a certain point, that is, you know. I don't know who it is or what that age is for everybody. But, yeah, man, it was like every time you found out something new or something just new just happened to present itself to you, or all of a sudden you find yourself actually doing some things, it's just like, oh, man, it just felt like you're winning. You know what I mean? Just like you said, that was victory right there. But, yeah, man, I think because of social media and the way that the parents of today are living, I think that kids today probably just don't have that much incentive to go through the levels. They just want to get straight to the point because it's right in their face every day. And I don't care what nobody say. You could have all the parental controls in the world you want, man. But if you got kids, man, that can maneuver their way around that, because if I was able to, they can. Because, you know, the different kid of today with social media and all the technological, you know, I won't call them advances, I'll just say changes. But all the stuff that you can get into, man, just makes sex something that's not something that you achieve anymore. It's just like, you know, they think it's a right or something like that. It's like, if somebody want to get with me, they better, ooh, yeah, you got the right to. Yeah, so much stuff, man. I can get into a whole bunch, man, but I'll just keep it as simple as I can because I'm old school. Yeah, he ain't lying, man. Every single time something new happened, even with me, even though I got started a little bit too early in things, it still felt like, yeah, something's different, you know. And then by the time you get to a certain age in your late, in your teenage years or even so on, all of a sudden you just find yourself getting into situations where you with a woman and then all of a sudden you're just, she looks at you like, what was that you was doing? Like, oh, like, where'd you learn that, man? Are we 30 or 40? That's what it felt like with me anyway, personally. It was just like, oh, I was always getting confronted with some twisted craziness. Yeah, craziness, man. I'll get into that at another day, back when a different platform comes available to start talking about all that stuff. But, yeah, man, I think that it should be something that you strive for as opposed to just like jump on in, like dive headfirst into a pool. Kids don't kiss like they used to. I think that is a very accurate assessment and statement at the same time. But yeah, very funny bit from him, man. He was making a lot of things clear. And I think now everyone really has an idea of what, you know, each other wants, you know, once you get a little bit older. So then all of a sudden it's like, okay, we don't have to feel like this is all awkwardness and then you have to go through a bunch of stuff. You know exactly what you want to get to, and everyone knows the time frame and everyone knows the scene and the circumstances. So yes, you got to learn how to get into all that stuff pretty much. And it's a slow process, you know what I mean? Don't want to speed up everything. Don't end up like this twisted fool right here. But yeah, very funny bit, man. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it off right there. One more time, Blaq Ron with Kids Don't Kiss Like They Used To. And if you like that reaction, please hit the like button for me one more time. Subscribe to the channel, ring that bell, and of course, as always, leave a nice comment for your boy. Constructive critiques, leave a nice suggestion or request, then throw a couple jabs, jokes, and zingers at me. Friendly dialogue, no drama here, all right? Please and thank you for always remembering. So, yeah, man, it's going to be Eddie BTV wrapping this one up. One more game here. Another good one from Blaq Ron. Man, I'm already can't wait to get to the next one of him. I wonder, does he have a special out at all that you guys know about? If he does, just let me know. I might search if I have a wild hair up my ass or something like that to check it out. But this dude's awesome. He's funny. And I think that if he doesn't have an hour special already, dude, you already ready for one. Come on, let's be honest. You got material for days, man. Put it all together, man. Make the fans laugh, man, because you awesome at that as hell already. So, yeah, awesome again to get to another one from him. Can't wait for the next one. And until next reaction, love and appreciate y'all. Peace.